back, everyone, to Rebellion Wrestling's Royal Madness 3. We are now getting ready for our first of two semi-final matches in the Royal Madness Tournament. The Mad Professor, the defending Royal Madness winner and Valley Young champion, going to the semi-finals of this tournament. And he's won this tournament twice in a row, and he's trying to go for the three-peat here tonight. I mean, that would be huge for the Mad Professor if he were to go back-to-back-to-back winning the Royal Madness Tournament. I know that Claire wants to see me in the backstage area at some point tonight, but I've made a deal to call these two semi-final matches before I go to the backstage area to talk to Claire and find out what Claire wants. And I guess Cameron will call some of the action at that point. But nonetheless, I get the opportunity to call these two semi-final matches as the one comes down to the ringside area. And the one, he's got to be very, very fired up for this opportunity, because you got to think he had to go through a lot to get into this Royal Madness Tournament. And he's been through so much in Valley Young Wrestling. I mean, becoming the interim champion, but then his victory was kind of short-lived as GL won an opportunity, and the one, being as nice as he is, decided to give GL that opportunity, knowing that GL is a monster, knowing that GL is the one heel legend, and so the one would love the opportunity to try to get a shot at the Valley Young Championship again. And I mean, now he's facing the Mad Professor, the Valley Young Champion. And the Mad Professor, of course, took a short vacation from Valley Young Wrestling for a while, but the one starting off strong here on the Mad Professor, knocking the Mad Professor out of the ring over the top rope. And the Mad Professor grabs a steel chair, comes back into the ring, and the one takes him down. And the one and the Mad Professor, these two, I'm sure that they would probably have a long-standing rivalry. And they've had a few matches, but the Mad Professor, in the last matchup, got the upper hand because it was a triple threat. And of course, as we've stated before, GL would love the opportunity to get the Valley Young Championship because he was the interim champion. But I believe he hit a receipt on the one, and that allowed the Mad Professor at the time to pick the bones in the unification matchup. And ooh, the Mad Professor misses that high-risk maneuver. But high-risk moves are high-risk, high-reward, or high-risk, high-consequence if you don't hit him correctly. And now the one going up to the top rope. And ooh, that moonsault right through the table. The same thing that he used on Max Frost. I guess the one is trying to use that same tactic of wearing down his opponent the same way that he did in the last matchup that he had with Max Frost. And of course, Max Frost and the one, it looks like they might have called a little bit of a truce to their long-standing rivalry that they've had, their feud that they've had. Of course, that all started when Max Frost was on commentary and said a few things that got under the one's skin. And the one, of course, had said some things that got Max Frost irritated. And I guess now, after all the talking and all the matches that they've had, they finally come to an agreement that as competitors, they can agree that they did have a very good matchup here tonight. But the one looks like he's staggering a little bit. But neither of these competitors can be feeling in the best of shape after their grueling quarterfinals matches. And the Mad Professor, earlier in the night, he was busted open. And now the one is trying to do whatever it takes to try and get the Mad Professor out. And that would be huge bragging rights for the one, as he would be the first guy to put a blemish on the Mad Professor's record here at Royal Madness. And now he's got him in the Wonder Bar center of the ring. The Mad Professor, though, is able to fight through that pain of that move. And now the one with the vision on the Mad Professor. The vision. And that might be it for the Mad Professor. I'm not sure how much more he can take. And now a cover. One, two, and no. A kick out there. A near fall there by the one. He almost ended the Mad Professor's dream of winning Royal Madness back to back to back. But no, the Mad Professor is now able to come back in this matchup. Ooh, the one knocks him takes him down from off the top rope. The Mad Professor perched there. Ooh, arm drag from off the top rope by the one. The one is really fired up and looks like he's determined and ready to try to go on to the finals of this tournament. And I don't know how much more the Mad Professor can go through in one night. I mean, he's survived other Royal Madness tournaments, but I don't know, the one might be his toughest challenge to date in this kind of a tournament. And now, the Mad Professor goes up to the top rope, and a suplex from off the top rope to the one. And looks like Mad, ooh, a kick right to the face. And no championships are on the line in this matchup, remember. The Ballydun Championship is not on the line. So the Mad, ooh, and that hero slam there by the Mad Professor getting fired up here. The one is down, and now the Mad Professor showboating a little bit for the crowd, and now a cover hooks the leg. One, no, and a kick out there by the one. And now the one, ooh, with a clothesline there, taking down the Mad Professor. The one trying to get fired up, trying to get motivated, trying to pull up. Ooh, and he's busted the Mad Professor open again. That cut that was, I guess, bandaged, stitched up, and closed up pretty good, has opened up yet again on the Mad Professor. So he's going to have to go see medical probably after this matchup, regardless of how the matchup goes. Cover one, no, and a kick out by the Mad Professor, because that cut's got to be closed up, because you know what, I'm bleeding like crazy. But this matchup, this mat is going to be stained with blood. So I don't know what's going to happen with this ring mat, whether they're going to cut it up and put it as a souvenir or what the deal is with that. But nonetheless, these competitors have left it all in the ring. And now the one, again with the Wonder Bar there on the Mad Professor, yet again, center of the ring. And the Mad Professor is able to fight through the pain yet again to survive thus far. And now the one, oh, the altered vision there by the one. And the Mad Professor is down. So I don't know how much more the Mad Professor is going to be able to sustain here as the one goes up to the top. Ooh! And an elbow drop from off the top rope. And now a cover hooks the leg. One. No, and a kick out there again by the Mad Professor. And the Mad Professor's got the one set up. The running power slam to the one. And now what's the Mad Professor going to do? He's going up to the top rope. Ooh! Off the top rope. Cover. One, two. No. No, he did not get the three. And now the Mad Professor goes up. Ooh, that same maneuver. One, two, three. The Mad Professor, I guess, has found a maneuver that works. That off-the-top rope leaping pinfall maneuver eliminates the one. And I gotta give the one a ton of credit for this kind of a matchup. I mean, the one went all the way to the semifinals, faced the Mad Professor, and you gotta give the one credit. I mean, I know Claire and the one have had tension, but I gotta give the one his due. He did do an impressive thing tonight, going all the way to the semifinals, but the Mad Professor, just too much in this tournament, and I guess that experience really does pay off in this tournament. Congratulations to the Mad Professor on going back to the finals yet again. This would be like an NBA team going to another final in the tournament or something, like they do every year. This could be like a football team going to the Super Bowl three times in a row, which I don't know has happened in a long time, but the Mad Professor gets now to the finals of the Royal Madness Tournament for the third time in a row. Congratulations to the Mad Professor on continuing this winning streak and going to the finals of the Royal Madness Tournament.